When I was brainstorming ideas for this series with my sister, we analyzed the seven deadly sins themselves in great detail for about 5 to 10 minutes before we suddenly realized that we had completely forgotten about Sloth. And you know, I don't blame us. By its very nature, Sloth is not a very flashy vice. Maybe that's why Sloth is kind of boring? I mean, part of this is just that he doesn't get a lot of screen time. I mean, the writers clearly put a lot of thought into him, but how do you make apathy interesting? Well, they tried. Sloth is a hulking muscle man who follows father's orders reluctantly while calling everything a pain and asking when he can go to sleep. It actually reminds me a lot of my sister. Though he is definitely not a dwarf, he does dig holes. Really, really extensive holes. Probably the most extensive hole network in whatever you call the world of a mestress. It's really groundbreaking. Why father thought his indolence was the best trait to do this job, I don't know, but it turned out pretty well for everyone except a mestress. All of the homunculi are extremely strong and tough, even without exercising, but Sloth really surpasses all of them. I mean, he can, without an ultimate shield, he can tank a tank slug to the chest without batting an... he doesn't have eyelids. He can tank a tank slug to the chest without wincing. He doesn't really seem to care about what he does. He only works under father's direct orders, and even then he never exerts himself. But when we do see him exert himself, he's terrifying. When he's sent to kill the Armstrong siblings, who are ridiculously tough, he eventually, after a long and arduous fight, begins to get annoyed. And then he reveals that he is the fastest homunculus. Granted, his aim is nothing to brag about, but the point is that the homunculi can be pretty fast. He has amazing potential. Also, the punishment for the slothful in, you know what? Constant running. As a side note, Sloth's resilience is very appropriate when you consider how freakishly hard it can be to overcome slothfulness. I mean, I can barely convince myself to get out of bed some mornings. His sluggishness also extends to his thought processes, once again pretty relatable. After a day of binging Netflix, I feel more like a pound of irradiated ground beef than a rational being. If indolence made you smarter, then my family alone would have cured cancer years ago. In the end, Sloth is defeated by husband of housewife and little Sparkle, two men who evidently put a lot of work into maintaining their physiques, and the two most terrifying women in Amestris who worked really hard to get the position and power they have. But Sloth isn't just defeated because these people are willing to give it their all and he's not. It's because, in the end, he's not even willing to give it a fight. His final words are,
"Am I dying now? For real? What is dying like? Such a pain to think about it, but such a pain living to you."
In the end, what destroys him is his own apathy. Sloth isn't doing useless things instead of useful ones. Sloth is trying to enjoy things without taking a part in them, without being willing to do something. If you commit enough to practically anything, you can make it useful. But Sloth doesn't give anything his all because he doesn't actually care about anything, even himself. He just takes the easiest path, and when the easiest path is dying, he gives up. Next up, just in time for June, is everyone's second favorite murder midget, Pride. Until then, go do something useful with your life, and as always, keep an eye out for me.